So first and 10 of the Rams offense gets ready. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Johnson Jets is free. Oh, scram for the football, and he's going to come down with it. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Back to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Tahir Whitehead. Coming in from his outside linebacker spot. He buries it for a loss of 10 or 11.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, five defensive backs, they just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback now got real quickly.
Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pickup there at 22.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket waiting for him to clear going across.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They're running man out of the gun. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to 48. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They'll rifle this one deep right. This is caught inside the 15. A big play there for LA. 41 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed. There he needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with it. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big time play right there.
So for that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Throw. Oh, it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
Can't be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
Well, look to throw. I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. Six-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. Third down here.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think we're trying to dial up there?
Well, knowing him and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've got to run out of your running plays, fire another one into the end zone.
How about the defensive stand here from first and goal, three straight incompletion?
Yeah, I think people wonder why didn't they try and run it at least once in there. But once the first incompletion happened, it's almost like they were committed to throwing the ball from then on out.
So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Back to throw here. Oh, escaping, he goes down. He couldn't get the ball away on fourth. fourth and goal. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. But they miss an opportunity to put some points on the board on the opening drive. They pass on the field goal, what'd you think?
I'm looking up at a positive standpoint for them. First drive of the game, they set the tone, right? They go downfield and let them know how aggressive they're going to be all game long. Even though they don't get it, because it's the first drive of the game, you're not that worried about it. Hey, we got plenty of other opportunities as this game moves on. That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. It looks like a pickup of six. That leaves him with 7 yards to go on third down.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third manageable with that run.
Throwing on third down, Newton. He completes it to Bryant. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. And the offense runs for a first down and 10. Start the drive. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. 75 yards. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that was part of their script because so many teams script their opening possessions. And then whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be right in there when they call a shot play. Go for the good one, and they got it done.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. Shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they'll be led out by the NFL's most valuable player from 2015. It's Cam Newton.
There are a number of great quarterbacks in the NFL, but I have to believe that the prototype in terms of look has to be Cam Newton. That stature and frame, almost breathtaking when you see him in person. And now he's starting to put it all together with consistency in his game, throwing, running, leading.
On first down, Newton. And his first pass is incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Hunter Henry. That'll bring up second down. Charles already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
And it's a run to run now. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And the offense lining up first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He's going to look deep down the field. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on to the second down.
This game is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
10 yards still left on second down. To throw again. Newton. And he fires. Wilkins intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And he returns it into enemy territory down the 45-yard line.
Well, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I get a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ends up making a play there.
He's got a rifle run deep left, and a man that's caught inside the 10. And all the way down to the 7-yard line.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive. It comes right back, and he's bringing it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
The pigskin on the 7-yard line now. It's first and goal. Play clock winding down. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A great effort there. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Rams add on to their lead.
And as many coaches' meetings as we sit in, we hear the word finish all the time, don't we? And on that play, the back actually finished getting into the end zone, breaking the last tackle. Tried to wrap up, tried to use a proper technique, just wasn't able to get it done.
Zerline now for the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. Zerline out now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now back out comes the offense. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early. Probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
Not much happening there on first down.
But there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Here's Newton. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. So the screen good for only 2. Now it's 3rd down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Newton now throw. That's complete. Henry. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Now it's Newton. On the slant, he gets it to Clark. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's Sacramento football here to begin the second, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Second down now. Campbell. And he's out of it. It's on the ground. And the Rams have got it back. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Not afraid, made a big play.
About 6 up to midfield.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
From the midfield strike, they're looking for it. That's coming, and down he goes. Andrick McKinney. Not dropping into coverage, he comes in the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Dante Hightower, he's the one to get him this time, and back-to-back sacks are going to bring up a 4th down.
Well, certainly some teams are not intimidated by down and distance on defense, are they? 3rd and very long? Let's go get this guy again. Big time pressure.
And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Offense ready to head back out there. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. If the crowd goes, first do no harm. But right now, they're having themselves on offense.
I like that. No wonder he's taking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. Just 1 yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That 1st down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. 2 minutes to go here in the 1st half. More from Minneapolis after this. Coming up at halftime, remember, we'll get you out to Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of this 1st half. That is, of course, unless you decide to skip him.
And for the record, we do not encourage that.
Now keep it on the ground. Campbell, and he's going to lose yardage back to his own 1-yard line. Now the Rams are going to hold things as they want a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. The fullback Jim gets the handoff, and he will forge his way forward only up to the 2-yard line. And a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Here's Sam Martin now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. And a return faster. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit and try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before.
The Green Bay Lions are going to somewhere else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something.
It's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. A big play there. 46 yards. Nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from what I said. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge.
You know, I'm like, yeah, nice P, you know?
What up, P?
Man.
What up,
what up?